getting horseshoes made up, decided against making any escrows. But I am going to make some decorative leaves to go on it. I'm going to make my leaves, these decorative leaves, make them out of that old piece of rod right there. I believe that's a half inch round stock. Well, that's what I'm going to make my leaves out of. I'm going to start out tapering this in. Now I'm hanging it over my side of my anvil. Now this time I'm going to try something new. As you can see, well, it really don't look like much anything right now. But we're fixing to start trying to turn that into the leaf. And I'm going to use this foolering tool. I haven't used that yet to make a leaf, but I'm going to try it and see if it works. This will be my test trial run for making a leaf with that. Now, let's see if this will work. Believe it. That might work, but it's not working fast enough for me. I'm going to use my ball peen hammer. Let's use the ball peen hammer to see if it did it fast. Yeah, that's working faster. It's actually leaving a little texture in there, making it more realistic looking. starting to look like a leaf. So this time I've swapped hammers again to go with my straight paint. See what it does. We'll do that one more time just to flatten it out a little bit more, then we'll put some shape to it. I'm going to use my straight paint again just because I like the marks, the hammer marks that it's leaving in it. See the marks. Now I wanted to leave them hammer marks in there. Gives a little bit more texture. I've got my chain on here again. That's going to be my third hand. I'm going to cut this so that I can make the stem on the leaf. I'm using another tool that I made, which I accidentally made it for this purpose. I was making something else and I messed it up. Instead of throwing it away, I decided to use it as a cutoff. A hot cutoff. Now, make sure my dog's ain't around. I don't see him. Now I just draw out the end of that to make the stem. I'm going to do that a couple more times, make a couple more leaves. There's many ways of making leaves, that's just the way I make them. I'm sure there's easier ways, and of course people's got their own ways, and That's just my way. Which really, I'm not making a tutorial on how to do it. I'm just showing how I do my leaves. Now, I was actually looking at a leaf whenever I was doing this. One is right here in the backyard. We'll compare. And most leaves, they're not all the same, they're not all perfect. So whenever I'm making something, I don't want it to be perfect either. I don't want it to look like somebody else's stuff, look like it's been machine made. I want you to be able to tell that it was handmade. I'm going to end this right here because it done got hot out here.